this is a section of downtown Los Angeles known as Skid Row. It's not a very nice neighborhood. In fact, it's filled with some pretty low characters. That's one of them standing there. Yes, it's me. I know it sounds fantastic, but the reason I'm dressed like a tramp is because I'm trying to get a hold of $18,000. A dime. Now all I need is $17,999.90. How did I get into this mess? Well, let's go back to last Thursday afternoon. I was out in Inglewood on an important assignment for the Thackeray Realty Company.
Oh, thanks very much, old timer.
Don't mention it, Mac. Say, can you spare a dime for a cup of coffee?
A dime? Let's see. Well, here's a quarter.
Hey, Mac, you were all right.
Wait. You're sure it's coffee you want this for, huh?
Well, I,
You don't seem very sure.
Well, sure, I'm sure. I was just trying to make up my mind whether I wanted hot coffee or hot chocolate. Thanks, Mac. See you around.
Hi, Julie. Is Thackeray around?
He's out on the Landers deal. Darn this stapler.
Now, Miss Marshall, mustn't fight it. Oh, yes, I think I see the trouble. Let her open it, please. There it is. Yeah, that's it. Perfect now. Julie, the secret's in the way you strike the machine sharply and precisely, like this. Get it?
Got it.
Letter opener, please. Thanks. Of course, the other secret is to keep your tie out of the way.
Oh, Bob, Mr. Thackeray said be sure to remind you to pick up the rent money on the Oak Street house.
Way ahead of him, Judy. I've already been there. I've got it, I've got the, Judy, my wallet. It's gone.
Oh, Bob. Now think, when did you have it last?
Let's see, I had it when I paid my restaurant check at noon. And then I went to Inglewood and... That hobo.
Hobo? What hobo?
But he was such a friendly old fellow, he'd never have taken.
Oh, true blue Beanblossom. When are you going to realize everyone else isn't as honest as you are?
Maybe I better go right back over there now.
Yes, I'm sure he's standing right there where you left him. Bob, didn't you ever hear of pickpockets? Here, call the police and report it.
Okay, Julie, if I don't get it back by tomorrow.
Call them now. You can't afford to lose that rent money.
Hello. Sergeant? I'd like to report a missing wallet, please. Robert S. Beanblossom. Beanblossom? B-E-A-N-B-L-O-S-S-O-M. I work for the Thackeray Realty. Oh, yeah. Well, I'm not positive, but I think it was stolen by a pickpocket a couple of hours ago. Oh, let's see. I'd say he's sort of a frowsy-looking bum. Yes, about 6 feet two, medium weight.
And twinkling blue eyes.
And twinkling blue... Oh, never mind, Sergeant. He's here now. Yes.
Here you are, Mac. Came back and found it on the sidewalk in front of that store.
Well, thank you very much. I never thought I'd get this back.
It's all there, $73.
Oh, I understand. I didn't distrust you or anything. It's just... Well, I guess I did, sort of.
Can't say I blame you. I am a little, frowsy looking.
Oh, Julie, I got my wallet back. This gentleman just returned it.
The money, too?
Yes.
It's possible to be a bum, miss, and still be honest.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean it that way. It was very kind of you.
No trouble at all, lady. I'm Jefferson Smith.
Oh, this is Julie Marshall, Mr. Smith.
How do you do, Mr. Smith?
Well, I better hit the road.
Oh, Jeff, just a minute. I want to talk to you. Just sit down. Look, I'm going to do something for you. You see this $5? Now, I could just give you this as a reward for your honesty, but that wouldn't do you any good.
It wouldn't?
No. See, a man like you needs more than money. He needs encouragement.
That $5 looks pretty encouraging.
Jeff, I'm going to see to it that you get 10 times $5.
In one lump?
In one lump.
What's the catch?
I'm going to put you to work.
Work? That's the thanks a guy gets for being honest. See you around.
No, Jeff, wait a minute. Don't you see, I'm giving you a chance to make something of yourself. I want you to come to work here for the Thackeray Realty Company.
Now, Bob, just a minute.
What do you say, Jeff?
You got a good pitch, Mac, but I like being a bum.
Now, remember, $50. Think of all the things you could do with it.
$50, huh?
That's right. You can get a haircut, shave, new clothes.
And think of all the hot chocolates I can buy.
Good, you're hired. Come on, I'll put you up.
Bob, you've forgotten something. Mr. Thackeray does the hiring around here.
Now, Jeff, see these wooden boxes? First thing I want you to do is to move these into the storage room.
I'm sorry, Mac. Can't do any lifting. Back trouble.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Well, let's see. Oh, the windows need washing. That's not very heavy work.
I don't know. Being around water, a man could get rheumatism or something.
Now, look here. No more excuses. Now, you start with my window and then work your way around the building and then sweep the front wall.
I hope none of my friends see me. I'd be blackballing every jungle camp from Miami to Tacoma.
Good luck. Congratulate me, Jolie. I put it over.
The Landers deal?
18,000 cash. Make out a deposit slip. I'll have Bob take it over to the bank.
Oh, but Mr. Thackeray, it's 3 o'clock now.
Oh, well, first thing in the morning. I'll keep it in the office safe tonight. 18,000 cold cash.
Watch it, Matt.
What in blazes is going on in here?
The boss hired me to wash the windows.
The boss?
Yeah, Beanblossom. I think that's his handle.
I might have known. Beanblossom! Oh. Hi, Mr. Thackeray.
Well, Bob, you've pulled some lulus in your time, but this beats everything. What's the idea of hiring that hobo in there?
What's the matter? Isn't he doing a good job with the windows?
Windows? He's got more water on my desk than he has on the windows.
Oh, well, I'll tell him to be more careful.
You tell him to get out. I'm not running a midnight mission.
Oh, Mr. Thackeray, we can't fire him. He needs friends like you and me.
Maybe like you, but not like me. I'm trying to run a respectable business here. And having a skid row bum around here like that isn't going to help the general impression.
Oh, Mr. Thackeray, you've got it all wrong. Jeff Smith isn't a skid row bum.
No? Well, what is he then?
Well, he's an old friend of the family's.
I've often wondered about your family, Beanblossom.
Yes. Well, it's a very tragic story, Mr. Thackeray. You see, that man in there was once a very successful business executive like yourself. Yes, pillar in his community, civic leader. I even taught Sunday school. And then came the crash, and Jefferson Smith was wiped out. Since then, it's been nothing but one bad break after another. He drifted lower and lower until the day when he met an old friend on the street. Me. But well, it's up to us, Mr. Thackeray. We can give this man a fresh start in life. What do you say?
Well, those things do happen, I guess. All right, Bob. He can stay. But if anything goes wrong...
Oh, thank you, Mr. Thackeray. You'll never regret this, believe me.
Julie, I'm stopping by the recorders on my way home. Good night.
Good night, sir.
Good night, sir.
He taught Sunday school.
What's that, Julie? Oh, yes, well, I guess I was a little carried away, but don't worry, it'll all work out.
Excuse me, mister, do you happen to have a dime for Hi. See you tomorrow.
Good night, Mr. Smith.
Look, this ain't going to work into anything steady, is it?
How long has it been since you've had a job, Jeff?
Well, I had a bad year in 51. Had to work 3 days. Say, Mac, you think maybe I could have a little advance?
Advance? Oh, yes, sure, of course. Here's $5.
Thanks, pal.
Now you'll get a shave and good meal and feel refreshed in the morning, huh?
Sure, Mike, sure. Be seeing you.
Say, Jeff, incidentally, you got a place to stay tonight?
Sure. There's a six bits a night flophouse down on Main Street where I generally book when I'm plush like this.
Main Street, huh? That's quite a ways off. I got an idea. Why don't you sleep in my office? I have an army cot you can use.
Well, six bits is six bits.
See, already you're thinking about saving money. Oh, this has been a great day in your life, Jeff. Just think, only this morning you were panhandling and now you're working for a living, huh?
Yeah. I really hit the skids.
Good morning, Jeff. Jeff?
Morning, Bob.
Oh, Julie, he's disappeared.
Who's disappeared?
Jeff. I let him use my office to sleep in last night.
You let that hobo stay here on... Oh, Bob.
What's the matter? What's the matter?
It's gone.
Gone? What's gone?
$18,000 in cash.
$18,000?
The lander's money. Mr. Fathery left it overnight in the safe.
Julie, you don't think... You can't possibly think that Jeff Smith...
I sure do, Mac.
Julie, I don't get it. I just don't get it. If Jeff Smith is a thief, then why did he return my wallet?
Don't you see? He was after bigger stakes. Your wallet was just a stepping stone to the $18,000. I'm calling the police.
No, wait a minute, Julie. I've got an idea. What time does Stacker say be in today?
Around noon. Why?
I'm going to give Jefferson Smith the benefit of the doubt.
Bob, where are you going?
To find him. If I'm not back here with $18,000 by noon, call the police, Julie.
But, Bob, you don't even know where to look.
He said something about a flop house down on Main Street. I'll super-rattle, I get a lead.
His kind protect one another. They'll never tell you anything.
Julie, remember the old saying, it takes a thief to catch a thief?
Yes.
Well, I'm going after a hobo. You're around shy?
Shy?
Yeah, around the loop.
Oh, Chicago. Yeah, great town. What's your racket, pal?
Me racket? Well, I'm a... That is, I used to... What's the matter?
Fingers Freddy. Why, I'd know this hand any place.
Yeah?
Your Fingers Freddy, one of the slickest pickpockets that ever snatched leather. I'm sorry, pal. Forgive me, Fingers. If I'd have known it was you, I'd have never touched the stuff. I'm Hogan the Heist. Not bad at prowling a pocket myself, huh, pal?
Yeah, not bad. Of course, I'd have got my things back without you even knowing it.
You ain't kidding, pal. You know you and me make a great team together?
Yeah, we would.
Sure. You got class. Me, I'm okay down here, but you're Beverly Hills material. What do you say we form a partnership?
Yeah, maybe. Hey, first I got a little business to take care of. See, a pal of mine took it on the lam. I'm trying to find him.
Well, maybe I can help you. I've been working the street for 2 weeks now. What's this guy's name?
I'm looking for Jeff Smith.
Oh, Jeff. Everybody knows Jeff. I seen him last night.
Yeah? What time?
Around midnight. Hey, I didn't know there was that kind of dough in panhandling. Old Jeff was sailing.
Sailing? Did he happen to mention the name of the ship?
Now, you big shot's got a sense of humor.
But Heist, I gotta find Jeff.
Well, I know where he hangs out.
Can you take me there?
Sorry. I'm working the crowd at the ball game this afternoon.
Well, wait a minute. You've got time. Look, it's It's only 11:30.
11:30? Seems later than that. 11:45.
It can't be. I just set my watch this morning.
Well, let's check it, pal. You're right. 11:30. Come on. There's your friend.
Jeff, I gotta talk to you.
Try this thing.
It's a little drastic, but...
It's all right, officer. I'll move along.
Jeff, Jeff, remember me, Robert Beanblossom?
Beanblossom? Fingers, you really get yourself a name.
Jeff, you remember, don't you?
Well, I can't say I... Oh, please, Mike. Don't make me go to work. Not today.
Oh, Jeff, I'm not here to make you go to work. I want to know what you did with the money.
The money? Oh, believe me, Mac. I wish I'd never seen that dough.
Oh, Jeff, what did you...
I blew it.
But you must have some of it left. Look in your pockets. But you couldn't have spent all that money in one night. Where'd you go?
Well... First, I went to Danny's joint and blew 45 cents for a square meal.
Yes.
And then to wash it down, I had a couple of hot chocolates.
Yeah, then?
And then I bumped into a couple of friends and bought some refreshments for them.
Yeah, and then?
Well, at that rate, it don't take long for $5 to disappear.
Jeff, look. You got $5?
Yeah.
Look, I'm talking about $18,000.
I had 18 G's.
Jeff, please, concentrate. What'd you do with it?
18 G's. And to think he was on my side of the street twice last night.
Hello, Julie. What a day for golf, huh? Judge Tracy called?
Oh, yes, sir. I told him you'd pick him up.
Good. Better pick up my clubs and be on the way.
Oh, I'll get them for you.
You don't have to bother, Julie.
Here you are, Mr. Thackeray. Have a wonderful time.
Thank you. Beanblossom in?
Oh, no, sir. He isn't.
I'll run him down a prospect, I suppose.
Well, yes, sir. He's on a pretty big deal.
Oh, I'm glad to hear. Oh, Julie, did Mr. Smith show up for work this morning?
No, he didn't.
Too bad. But I guess when a man hits the skids. Oh, my golf ball.
Oh, I'll get them for you, Mr. Thackeray.
Wait till I get that judge on the course today. No, Julie, there's nothing like new golf balls to take a couple of strokes off a man's game.
But Mr. Thackeray.
Yeah?
The safe.
Yeah, what about it?
Didn't you notice it was empty?
Yes, I noticed.
But Mr. Thackeray, the folder with all that money.
Oh, no, that money wasn't stolen, Julie. I got to worrying about leaving $18,000 here in the office, so I came back last evening and took it home.
You took the money?
Yes, isn't that all right? It's my money.
Oh, Mr. Thackeray, of course it's all right. Wonderful, wonderful, Mr. Thackeray.
$18,000 was in that safe, and it ain't there now. Well, I... guess I took it. Oh, my fault.
No, Jeff, it's my fault. I'm just as guilty as you are.
That's the way the cops will figure it, Fingers, especially with your record.
I'll never be able to face Mr. Thackeray again.
Oh, you won't have to. I got a friend who'll get you over the border into Mexico.
Mexico?
That's a great idea, Fingers. Then when the heat's off, we come back and we make a fresh start in Beverly Hills.
I'll go get this guy lined up.
No, Jeff, wait a minute. It wouldn't be right to run away. We've got to give ourselves up.
You mean we should turn ourselves into the cops?
It's the only honorable thing we can do.
I'm hearing things.
Yeah, I'll go along with this honorable stuff as well as the next guy. But there's a play to draw the line.
Look, we've got
to
do it, Jeff. We owe a debt to society.
Fingers, don't talk like that.
Okay, so we owe a debt to society. But let's not make it so easy for them to collect.
The police.
Now, wait. Let's think this thing out.
Yeah, this kind of talk annoys me.
I got it, Mac. What do you say we make a deal with this guy, Thackeray?
A deal?
Sure. I can work off the money. Let's see. If I make a buck an hour, work a 30-hour week, there's 52 weeks in the year. 18 G's to pay back. Mac, let's go to Mexico.
And live a life where we'll be hunted like wild animals? No, Jeff. We've got to turn ourselves in.
I don't get it, pal.
Me neither.
Look at it this way. It'll free our conscience to give ourselves up. We'll be better men for it.
Yeah?
After all, a man has to live with himself.
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe it's for the best. Let's do it.
Believe me, Jeff, we're doing the right thing.
Hey, wait! You guys can't run out on me.
Now look here, Hogan. We're going to the police.
Well, can I go with you?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Hi, Willis.
Hey, sharpening up for me, eh, Judge?
New putter.
Oh.
Willis, you give me 3 strokes on the back nine, and I'll take you today.
3 strokes?
Mm-hmm. That's your idea of justice. Hope I never show up in your court. Judge Tracy. Yes, Bailiff. Well, I was just leaving, but... What? They insist on being arrested? I never heard of such a thing. Very well, send them in. Afraid I'm going to be tied up for a few minutes, Willis.
Oh. Well, I'll put your clubs in the car. Hmm? Be back in a minute.
Good. Come in. I don't understand that you men insist upon being jailed.
But that's right, Your Honor, and the sooner the better.
We don't want no lawyer, Judge. We just want to go to jail.
Could you please make it Alcatraz, Your Honor? I got some friends up there.
Oh, just a second. Before I can act in this case, I must investigate the evidence.
Please, sir, put us in jail and throw the key away.
Beanblossom!
Mr. Thacker. You didn't have to turn me in, sir. I just gave myself up.
That outfit, old Bob.
Oh, you've been a good boss, sir. Don't worry about my coming back to the firm. I wouldn't expect the Thackeray Realty Company to hire an ex-con.
But, Robert, my lad,
Bob, I've been looking all over for you.
Oh, Judy, it's all right. You didn't have to come down either. The dirty work's all done.
Bob, will you let me say something?
My name's ruined, Mr. Thackeray. Say anything. Say anything you want to.
That money wasn't stolen. I went back to the office and took it home with me.
Call me a thief. Call me a...
Let him go, Judge. I'll explain everything to you on the way to the golf course.
Your word's good enough for me, Willis. Case dismissed.
Excuse me.
I beg your pardon.
Oh, of course, gentlemen. Gentlemen, just a moment.
My brand new golf ball. My watch.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, lady. That's the best handout I've had all day.